So as I said, this is the last lecture before the midterm, and we're going to continue what we started on Tuesday regarding passing class objects to functions. So last time we have seen one example of passing a class object by value. We are going to show that this does not work all the time, so we need sometimes to pass by reference. And we are going to talk also about returning class objects from functions. And quickly introduce the friend functions, which is something between member functions and non-member functions. Non-member functions do not have any access to the class private members. Member functions have full access, but friend functions are in between. So let's look at both those points. Without further delay, let's start with the same example, the class definition. So we have this rectangle class, like every time, with the private section, the public section. Public section has two constructors and one destructor. How do we know them? Constructor has the is a function. It has the same name as the class name, exactly. We call this a default constructor because it does not have any parameters, and the second one, a parameterized constructor, because it has parameters. In this case, it has two parameters. This is a destructor that is also a function with the same name, member function with the same name as the class, that starts with a tilde operator or a tilde symbol. And destructors never have parameters, and all of these constructors and destructors do not have any return types. Then we have two setters and two getters for the two data members, the two member variables that set and get the values of the private length and width. If we are going to access the length and width from outside the class, this is when we need the setters and the getters. And similarly, we have a member function that is a general member function that computes the area of that rectangle, because we understand from the names of the class of the data fields that this is the length of a rectangle, this is the width of a rectangle, so area would probably be the product of both of them. The default constructor assigns default values whenever we declare a new object of type rectangle. Any new object of type rectangle that is declared will have initial values of 1 and 1 in the length and width values. This is what this function is saying. As for the parameterized constructor, it will assign whatever values we give as parameters to the constructor. Again, we said the constructor function is never explicitly called. But it is automatically called when we declare a new object of type rectangle. Which constructor is called depending on the way we declare that object. If we declare the object without parameters, then it calls the default constructor. If we declare an object with two parameters, then it calls the parameterized constructor. This destructor does not do anything. And this is how you would have it would have been defined if you, even if you did not define one. So if you do not define a destructor, then a default destructor is defined that doesn't do anything, that looks exactly like this destructor you can see on the screen. We have seen the destructor in the context of deleting dynamically allocated data. And we said that if we don't need to do any garbage collection or cleaning or clearing of memory, then we don't need to declare the structure because it is already there. Those are the setters and getters. Gets a value from outside the class as a parameter and then stores it inside the private data field. The member functions, we know that this is a member function because it is defined using the scope resolution operator. We know it is a member of the class rectangle because before the scope resolution operator, we have the name of the class in which it belongs, to which it belongs. Inside the member function, we can use the names of the data fields directly, length and width, even though length and width are not defined in the scope of this function. But they are defined in the scope of the class in which the member function is defined. Get length, set length are defined inside the class. That class also has members length and width. Yes, they are private, but they are private for the data and the functions outside the class, but they are not private for the members of the same class. So we can use them directly, length and width. We are going to know which length and width, the length and width of which object we are dealing with by looking at the calling function. When we call this function, it is called using an object, using the dot operator. So I'm going to look at it right now. Okay, this is the function we have seen last time, print rectangle. Print rectangle is not a member function. This is how do I know it is not a member function? Yes, there is no scope resolution operator. There is no scope resolution operator, and before which appears the name of the class to which it belongs. So from this definition, we know it is not a member of any class. Also, from the definition of the class, we can see that it does not exist here. But this definition is enough. This definition tells me this function is outside any other class. If it is outside the class, then it must be passed a parameter. Here the parameter is of an object of the type rectangle class. And this is where we stopped last time, so let's look at it again before proceeding with today's lecture. We first declare an object of type rectangle. How is it declared? By reserving some space in memory and calling that space R1. And how about the 2 and 3? They are stored here, the length and width. How do I know this happens? When we declare an object, the compiler is going to search for constructors. Do we have constructors for the class rectangle? Yes, we have two of them, not only one. Yes, we have two constructors. Do we have a constructor that has two parameters? Yes, we have. So we're going to use that constructor, which takes the first value and stores it in length, and the second value and stores it in the width value, in the width variable. So this is how the first step is done. Then it prints before modification, okay. Then it calls the function print rectangle. Now, how do we call the function print rectangle? We have two ways. Can we call the function print rectangle like this, R1 dot print rectangle? Because this is how we have been calling functions since we started studying object-oriented programming and the classes. When is a function called using the dot operator? When do you call a function using the dot operator? Class. If this function is a member is a member of the class which R1 is an object of. For example, R1 is an object of type rectangle. Then if you call print rectangle using a dot operator with R1, then it means you are telling the compiler that print rectangle is a member of the class of which R1 is the type of. Here R1 is of type rectangle, so you are telling print rectangle is a member of rectangle.
And let's check. No, this is not correct.
Print rectangle is not a member of any class.
So it is not allowed. It is not allowed to, this is wrong. It is not allowed to call a non-member function using the dot operator. Because when we have a dot operator, then the first thing that the compiler looks at is it a member of the class of this object, R1? No. Then you cannot call it like this. On the other hand, member functions, can give me an example of member function, any one of those, set L, set W, get length, get W, anyone, are not allowed to be called without an object before them. For example, I would like to call get W. Is it allowed to call get W like this? Just like this, get W? No, why not? Because we don't have a function getW that is defined outside the classes. We only have getW defined inside a class. The class is rectangle, so you must use dot operator with an object of type rectangle, the same type in which this function is defined. This function is a member type. So this is the first thing. How do we call the function? Second thing, after we call the function, what happens? R1 is moved, is copied as a argument that is passed into R, correct? Because they are in the same location. Which means we enter the function, and inside the function we have an R object, and this R object equals R1, because assignment was defined for objects of type class, then it is allowed to do this. 2 is passed here and 3 is passed here, and we have 2 and 3 inside the R. What else do we have? That's it. Now we're inside the function. We have an object R that has the values 2 and 3. We can use this object inside the function. I use it like this, r.getLength, r.getW. Is it allowed inside this function just to see out length?
No.
Why not?
Private.
More than private. Length is not defined here. Length is not defined in the scope of, not defined at all. Yeah, the أشد من private. هنقول private دلوقتي. Length is not defined in this scope. خلاص. But length here was defined in the scope of this function. فين definition? فين double length is not defined inside the function, but it is defined in the same scope. بمعنى it is defined in the same class of which this function is a member. Then they are defined in the same scope. I can use, we can think of width as global, global بالنسبة للكلاس. With respect to the class, it is global, so I can use it. If you have another definition, if I have another definition of width inside the function, it will be local. And if you use width, it will use the local width, not the global one. And in the different level. But for now, I don't have a definition of width inside those member functions, so I'm going to use this one.
Right. Only member functions can do this.
So we know that this is wrong because length is not defined, not declared. Type, can we write inside this function, see out, do we have R? So R dot length?
No.
هنا بقى إجابتك صحيحة. Because length is private. So here length is not defined at all. But here length is defined as a is defined as a member of R1, but as a private member of R, and this function is not a member function, so it cannot access the private members. So we must use a public member function of the class of which R is an object of. For example, here R is an object of type rectangle, so we must use a member of rectangle class so that we are able to print the 2 and 3, and this is what happens here, 2 and 3. Then we call the other function modify rectangle. Again, modify rectangle, from the way it is called, من تصيغة الاستدعاء, it is clear to us that modify rectangle is not a member of any class object. It is not a member of any class object. And from the definition of modify rectangle, indeed, it is not a member of any class object. So in that case, the object is passed to it as a parameter, in addition to more parameters. So let's look inside this function. What happens? Again, R1 is passed. Okay, 7 and 9 are passed. Yosef. So this is the R1 that was in the main, and now we are inside the function. We have R, we have length, and we have a width, and they all get the 7, 9, 2, 3. Where is the 2 and 3 passed? Are passed into R. The 7 is passed into length, and the 9 is passed here. Okay? Inside the function, what does this function do? It just calls the setL and setWidth member functions of R. What do those functions do? They take the values of length and width and store them inside R. So here, well, let's see another color, for example. This becomes 7, because 7 is copied here. And this becomes 9, because 9 is copied here. So this is 7 and 9, and this is R. Well, what is the purpose of this function? It does some error validation. It is going to, just to check if the length and width are negative and reject and produce some error message if this is the case. But if it is not the case, like 7 and 9, they are positive, they are going to be stored. What happens after this function exits? After this function exits, all the local data, what is the local data of this function? R, length, and width. All the local data is destroyed. And we exit the function, and we return back to main. What do we have in main? R1 equals 2 and 3. So this is what happens when you try to print R1. R1 is still 2 and 3, no change. So how do I make a function that modifies the value of R1? What do you think? Both answers are correct. For example, Nadifa said, we can use a return statement, returns that outside. But Abrar and Sharifa said, we can use a reference. So let's see both answers, which both of them are correct. This is how we use a reference, just exactly the same function header. Except that our first parameter, the object parameter, is a reference. The same thing happens inside the function. R1 is passed by reference from the main function into the function and returned back. So it's a round trip. Is passed to R and the value is returned. Actually, R points back to R1. So what happens is that the R1 is modified, and in that case, the the R dot length, which is equal to 7 inside the function, and R dot width, which is equal to 9 inside the function, are also passed to R1 inside the main. So this is why the modification works. If we are going to use a reference variable, we call the function exactly the same way that we called it without a reference parameter, with a copy parameter. Okay? The function call is not changed. Same function call. صح ولا مش صح? Same function call. If we call the function using a return, so there are more modifications that need to be done. First thing, we need a return statement. If we have a return statement, then we must have a return type. What will be the return type here? The name of the class. This function returns object of the type of the class. Not only that, the way we call the functions should be changed. How do we call the function if we have a return? We call the function using an assignment statement. Using assignment statement, so that the result is stored in that object, in the returned object. Because what if we have a return, okay? But still, we call the function like the previous slide without return. If we call the function using that way. So if we have a return, but we call the function this way, modify a rectangle, R1, 7, and 9. So we're going to call the function exactly the same way. R1 is going to be passed into R, one way only. Modification, return. Where does the return go? It is lost. So unless we have an assignment statement and a variable that takes the return value, R1 is not changed. خلاص واضح الكلام ده؟ واضح ولا مش واضح؟ So here the function is used to modify the value of R1. طيب. So we have talked about passing a class object to functions, pass by value, pass by reference, and returning objects, class objects from functions. Now we would like to talk about friend functions. As we said, friend functions are a type of functions that are not member functions. Friend functions are not member functions. Okay, so they are like any regular function. But they are an exception. Exception to which rule? They are an exception in that they can access the private members of a class. So friend functions are not allowed, are allowed to access the private members of the class to which they are friend. Otherwise, they are not a member of that class. They are a friend of a class, but not a member of a class. So it is something in between the non-member and member. So how do we know that they are friend of a class if they are not member of that class? So let's go directly to the definition, because here it says you must precede نسبق definition of a friend function by the keyword friend. And we must declare it anywhere inside the class of which it is a friend. Like this. This is again the same class. It has the same member functions, but it has one extra function defined inside the class. But unlike any other member functions, what does it start with? Keyword friend. Keyword friend. Friend before the void, before the return type. So the first three functions do not have return types at all. What are they called? Constructors and destructors. Those functions have return types only, and they are defined inside the class. What do we call them? Member functions. Member functions. The last function is defined inside the class. It does have a return type, but it is preceded by the keyword, reserved keyword, friend. So what do we call this? A friend function. A friend function. A friend function is not a member of a class, so it is called like any non-member function without the dot operator. But the difference between the friend function and non-member function, it is allowed to access directly the private data members, length and width. It means that r.length is okay. r.width also okay. So by looking at the example, print rectangle now is a friend function. How do we know? From the definition. Friend of which class? Friend of the class inside which it is defined. It is defined to be friend. This makes it a normal non-member function. You have to pass a parameter. You cannot use the dot operator, but you can use the dot operator to directly access the private fields. Type. Inside a friend function, can we use length and width directly? Length and width directly. Maybe you say yes because it is a friend. But the correct answer is no. Why no? You can access them only using a dot operator. We were able to access length and width directly inside Rahufin. We were allowed to use length and width directly inside the member functions. Why? Because length was declared inside rectangle and width was declared inside the class rectangle. And getW is a member of that rectangle. But the friend function is not a member of this class. The friend function is not called using dot operator. r.the function. So because it is called directly without dot operator, inside the function I don't know length and width of which object. The dot operator passes to the function the object that is on the left of the dot. We call member function using an object. But non-member functions like print rectangle are not called using an object. So the length and width are not defined at all inside the friend function. Again, the length and width are not defined at all inside non-member function like the friend function. Length and width are defined and understood only inside the member functions. Why? Because to call the member function, you need to use an object. And this object has length and width. Then length and width belong to the object that called the member function. But since print rectangle is not member function, you cannot call it using an object. So length and width are not defined. Are not defined because we don't know which object. Instead, you pass the object as a parameter. Since the object is passed as a parameter, then you can use r.length and r.width. Then the width of R, the length of R, this understood. Length only, just without any object, with or without any object, we don't know. طيب can we use inside a friend function r dot get length the public member function or r dot get w? Is it allowed to use those member functions? Yes, it is allowed to use them anywhere, even in member functions. But member functions have a privilege, لهم يعني ميزة أو خاصية that they can access directly. So it is correct, but it is not needed. If we can access directly, then it is much faster than calling a function, passing control to that function, and then returning from that function. It takes a lot of time. Even though it is not wrong, it is not incorrect to use the member functions, we can use حتى في سيدك فاتن يخلي بقى انت محترمة وما اسمت انت برضو محترمة يعني بس ماشي استنيني بس بعد المحاضرة خلاص ف r.length is allowed and r.get is also allowed but you don't need to waste time by passing control to the function and returning from that function back to here and you have the privilege like الخاصية الميزة زي واحد مثلا ايه يعني مع فلوس كتير يعني ما شاء الله ربنا فتح عليه بس يشتري أرخص سيارة مثلا بس طبعا انت معك تشتري عربية يعني استمتع بالفلوس اللي معك مثلا يعني فانا it has the privilege to access the private data members directly but it is allowed to call the in fact any function friend or non-friend حتى ال member functions طب ايه رأيكم في السؤال ده member functions member اللي can access directly with length and width حتى without object can you use can you call another member function inside the member function yes member functions can be because they are public they can be used anywhere they can be used in the class inside the class they can be used in friend functions they can be used outside friend functions حتى in the main But if you are a member function, استفيد من النعمة اللي ربنا اداها لك انك member function where you can access directly the length and width. If you are a friend, استفيد من المميزات, use your privileges. خلاص؟ يبقى it is not wrong, but it is not needed. How about modify rectangle? Is modify the same modify rectangle, the version, second version of Latifa, that returns an object of type rectangle. Is it member of any class? No. Is it friend of any class? No. No, it is a function that is neither member not nor friend. So we only have one choice but to use the public member functions set length and set width to access the private data field inside a non-member, non-friend function, we cannot use r.length wrong. We cannot use r.width wrong. We cannot use length. We cannot use width. All those are incorrect for us because it is neither member nor friend. Type friend functions. How are friend functions called, invoked? Friend functions are called exactly the same way as non-member functions because they are non-member functions. Yani, this is the correct way of calling a friend function. But R1 dot print rectangle is incorrect. You cannot call a non-member function, even if it is friend, by using the dot operator. If we have a dot operator, if we have the dot operator, then the function must be a member of the class of which this object is a type of. But print rectangle is not a member of the class rectangle of which R1 is an object. So we cannot use r1.print rectangle for non-member functions. We cannot declare print rectangle using scope resolution operator. Plus, even scope resolution operator in that context will be wrong, because print rectangle, even though it is defined inside the class rectangle, but it is defined as a friend, which means non-member. Here, modify rectangle again is the same modify rectangle we have seen before, and it works. So it makes the modification. Why does it work? Because the value of modify rectangle is returned and saved using an assignment statement in an object of type rectangle. في أي تعليقات تانية؟ I think that's all. خلاص شكرا. بخصوص الامتحان طبعا يعني as we said the quiz number 5 covers structures and the question about structures will be writing code. خلاص I already posted this on the Moodle, the details, and two questions about classes, but they do not involve the non-member functions, only member functions and constructors and destructors. So basically, tutorials 4 and 5. And of course, the lectures that those tutorials are based on. ما الدسم مطلوب الدسم مطلوب علشان تبقى صحتك كويسة. We still have tutorial 6 for the midterm. خلاص I will post it after this lecture إن شاء الله. Tutorial 6 in the midterm, so I want you to study as much as you can. And we have finished already يعني covering tutorial 5 and we have finished the lectures يعني 1 week ago. Tutorial 3 you already studied the pointers. Tutorial 3 covered the pointers and you already studied the pointers. So I prefer that you study this more. And if you don't do well, you have two other quizzes that can cover up, because I will count only the two best quizzes. خلاص. So what I want you to do now, tutorial 5 is long but easy. Tutorial 6 is shorter. Okay, I will post it now on Moodle. It is shorter, but it has more tricks, friend functions. It has non-member functions. And I can see from tutorial 1 that you have serious problems with understanding functions and calling functions and local variables and global variables and pass by value, pass by reference. So I believe that tutorial 6 is difficult. Yeah, not difficult, but it has more ideas. But tutorial 5, yes, long, but it is easy, very easy. Very easy. Yalla, shukran.